All right, quick gig here. I want to make this shorter than it was going to be. Nothing fancy because I found the problem early. But you're going to see a bunch of oil, that is engine oil, around. That's where I've actually already drained the other parts out. Over the backfill blade, a lot of stuff leaking from underneath. So what happened was I was loading the excavator onto the trailer to take to the fire station. Actually, we're going to remove a flagpole base. That'll be another video. But when I got it up on the trailer, low oil alarm sounded, and I looked and there was oil leaking out like pretty significantly. And boy, that scared me. I was just lucky it was in place on the trailer, really within a foot, moved it, swung the boom around and loaded it the way I normally do, and then turned everything off. So here's what the deal was. I got into the engine compartment. You really can't see much really well, but if you start having a heavy oil down there, it could be just a few things. Either a punctured oil filter, is there a line somewhere, what, you know, just start looking around. Well, the only time I kept wiping it down and seeing most of the oil was right around the top of the oil filter. So got in there, just got it off, and hopefully we can see this pretty well, but the oil filter ring blew out. This happens to be, this is actually fairly new, a couple hundred hours on it. The service manual says at 100 hours to do the drive unit. That was done at 100 hours. At 250, I think it's a suction filter. There's another video on that. And it says to change the first oil at 500 hours. For a new engine, to me, that felt a little bit late. So I'd actually already changed the oil at 250 hours just because, you know, I thought it was worth it. So we're just a little right around 500. So I'm gonna stay on schedule, but probably change my oil every 250 hours. So this has been on here for basically 250 hours, and then you just had a sudden blowout. You can see the ring. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take this around. We can get a little bit more light on it. Set it down. I'll set it out here over near the track, so let's take a closer look at it. If you can see where there's an inner lip that this is tucked under. However, it's not just that it came out of that lip, it actually busted here and came out of that seal. Now, I've always had a good practice. I mean, I put a lubricant on there when you're spinning it on hand tight. So not really sure why this busted out, unless something in the overpressure of the bypass failed or whatever it was. It was gonna be a startup on cold. In fact, this morning, matter of fact, I'll just go ahead and show this. This is the KX713, and this is a, I covered it up on much, HH160-32093 filter. I got some cross references for this too, but I went and ordered one. Now, the filter won't come in until tomorrow. No problem, I've got extra oil here, I'll just do it tomorrow. And the reason this, actually found this out a couple days later, this was on Wednesday, got it home, actually didn't feel well. Been sick for a couple days, took off work, and I just now got to walk out here and just take a look at this. So it's been two or three days of NyQuil and a negative COVID test, jazz. But yeah, this is, it was about 21 degrees this morning, so this is going to take a while to drain. I'm really just going to let this sit open all night, let everything drain out of that, wipe things down. But this is the deal, blown out. So if you get it right around that area where this is mounted up in there, and it's a straight drip down in that area, constant flow, this may be a good source of one of your problems.